Is it clear what happened on that night yet and subsequently?
So right now it is. You know, I think some parts are still under investigation, but I think most is known. Basically what happened was they were walking out of their high school in Kfar Etzion, which was the area, waiting for a ride home. The three of them boarded a car, which unfortunately happened to be abductors from Hamas. Within 8 to 10 minutes, they understood they were abducted. What happens is one of the boys gave a distress call to the police hotline. And what turned out to be a chilling coincidence, as this call went on, his phone fell to the ground. And for 2 minutes, what we hear is basically the cold-blooded execution of these three boys.
Does it worry you, concern you, bother you, that for a long period of time after that, even though it seems the authorities in Israel had received that call, that there was an impression that these guys had been abducted, but possibly were still alive?
We were told privately that they were quite pessimistic. They heard gunshots, and yet there was hope that one, possibly two, remained alive. We've seen these things in the past with Gilad Shalit and others. Keeping alive is a part of the motivation of Hamas. We had these hopes. Now, the probability was not high. We knew it all along. But when you have hope, when you do not have counter evidence saying they are dead, you hope they're alive.
Can Arabs and Jews live together going forward?
I have many pretty close Palestinian friends. I have no doubt the answer is yes. We can live in peace. I believe we will live in peace.
If there were one message that you wanted the world to hear about the death of your nephew and what you hoped perhaps might be his legacy, what would it be?
It's one of, you know, of justice, of fairness, of goodwill. These are probably, you know, the things I can think of. And by the way, out of justice, out of goodwill, comes peace, comes freedom. These are the things.